Hi everyone, welcome to Python Learning Series for Network Engineers. In this video, we'll see how to scan range of port in a remote machine to identify whether that is reachable or not. In the previous video, we have seen how to scan particular port in a remote machine. You can see here, it will check the port number of 80 in 0.10. Let's try executing it. You can see the status here, whether it is not reachable or not. In this video, we'll see how to give a range of port for each host. So for the first video, I'll add the URL in the description and notification. You can have a look to understand this script. So for the scan range, I'll create another file here. I'll give the file name 02 underscore. Port range. And here I'll replace this function name. The port check function name I'll replace with scan range. You can give any name here. And here the inputs are going to be IP, then starting port number and end port number. I'll call SP and EP. And here when we scan through the range of port numbers, we need to iterate through each port numbers. So for that, what we need to do is we need to create a for loop. So I'll create a for loop here for port in, then we need to give input as this range, starting port and end port. Then I'll call, give this range SP comma EP. So now what it will do, it will iterate through each port number and that port number will get added here. Now let's put this under for loop. Now for each port number, it will give the IP port and it will scan the result. So let's try running it. For 0.1, I'll give starting port 75 and end port 80. Let's try executing it. So you can see here, it is not, none of the ports are listening here, but it scanned only till 79. So what we can do here, now here under the function, what we'll do, we'll give EP equal to EP plus 1. Let's try executing it again. Yeah, now you can see it is scanning till port 80. Now let's add one more host here. Host 10. And I'll give 81. Now let's try executing it. So you can see here, it is printing the status of both hosts. We'll add, to separate each host, we'll add a print statement here. Print, and we'll give a slash n here. New line, then plus, into 10, then we'll add one message saying that scanning, then we'll give the IP address here. It will take IP from here. Plus IP plus okay, let's try executing it. You can see here, now it is separating for each IP. So it is scanning for individual IP and it is printing the message. Now here, if we give some kind of exception, like with your wrong IP. Now you can see I'm getting an exception in the terminal and it is not continuing. So what we can do, we'll try to handle that exception here. So to handle the exception, what we can do, we'll use try except method. We'll give try here, and this complete code we need to move under try. And if there is any exception, what we'll do, we'll print an exception. Okay. Yeah, now let's try running the script. So you can see here, for scanning 0.10, there is an exception occurred, and for 0.1, it is successful. Now let's remove this. Let me save the script and execute it again. Yeah, now you can see it is scanning the port range. I hope this video was helpful. In the next video, we'll see how to check the FQDN of a remote host and how to resolve an IP and how to print an exception if we are not able to resolve the IP. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.